It's a beautiful, typical sunrise over the East Cape of Baja, where we're fishing out of the Hotel Palmas de Cortez in the town of Los Barriles, which is about an hour's drive from Cabo San Lucas. It's late February, which is considered the off-season for fishing, but the action for winter species such as yellowtail can be fantastic. We're towards the end of the run for yellowtail in this area, but with any luck, we should be able to hook up. We're with Jimmy Diaz and his two daughters, Amy and Frida. Jimmy owns and operates both Can-Do Rentals and the Can-Do Restaurant in Los Barriles, and is an avid fisherman. We're running to Sorabo Island, which acts as the gateway to the Gulf of California, that all migrating fish must pass by. Its official name is actually Jacques Cousteau Island, named after the famous French underwater explorer, who called this area the Aquarium of the World. The clear, fertile water is home to incredible numbers of fish species, such as the sardines, that provide a food base for the larger predatory species, such as yellowtail. With a live well full of bait, it's time to go fishing.
Okay, we made it. We're to the spot. Never been this far before, this side of the island. This is kind of cool. Obviously, when you see the other boats here, you know you've come to the right spot, hopefully. So we're gonna put some live bait down, and I'll probably work some iron and see what's happening. This is gonna be fun. So you're spraying water to try to mimic the bait, try to bring the fish up. I've never seen them do that down here before. I've seen other places, but first time.
With our live baits out and some occasional chumming to draw the fish in, it didn't take long to get our first hookup. But not with the target species. Frida has caught a bonita, which is a fun little fish, but not the yellowtail that we're after.
Alright, looks like Jimmy's got her first hookup here.
Alright.
I don't think this is a bonita. We caught a bonita first, but now I think, or it's a big bonita. You know, yellowtail are a jack. They're the yellowtail amberjack is what their full name is. Lots of fish called yellowtail. The yellowtail amberjack is what we're catching here. It's a white-meated fish. It's not tuna. Some people call them tuna, but they're not a tuna. But they're still really good eating. Fun to catch, and I think we got one here. Oh. It's another bonita. Right on.
Yeah.
These are striped bonito, which are common in this area and are considered good eating. There are several other species, such as black skipjack, skipjack tuna, and Pacific bonito that look similar but aren't considered a quality food fish. If you see the captain filleting your catch, you know you've caught the right one. This is a black skipjack that fell for a fish field jig. These grow fairly large and are great fun as a catch and release species.
Well, Jimmy's hooked up out here. You're using live bait though, right?
You dropped a jig.
A jig? Oh, right on. Got a jig fish. Cool. Another.
Pretty good.
Yeah. Well, it's another bonito. But you like eating these, don't you?
Yeah,
well,
this one is very good to eat.
Yeah.
Good for sashimi.
Oh, yeah. There he is. Captain made a big turn. The fish came right at me. I thought I lost it for a second. But yeah, we got, this is definitely a yellowtail. we're doing is live bait. We're fly lining live sardines. I did get... There he goes. Just gonna let him run.
But you know, earlier
I was jigging these Spro jigs and I hit that too. My capitano wanted me to switch to live bait. So when the fishing's slow, you don't argue with the captain, you know? Yeah. I don't have a cushion. My cushion, I forgot to bring one. They usually have them on the boat here.
Yeah. No tienen la.
Oh, they got a cushion. Oh, it's like, that'll get you. That's no fun in your belly.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, here we go. Now we're talking.
Yeah.
Particularly big one, you know. These are it's a yellowtail amberjack, right?
Yeah.
That's what it really is. It's in the jack family, like a rooster fish or a jack crevalle or an amberjack. So they're strong, but I don't think this guy is real big. Fish right there, perfect eating fish. We like that, huh? Bueno.
Yeah.
We ended up with one yellowtail and lots of bonita and skipjack on this trip. But the great thing about fishing in Baja is that it's not always about catching lots of fish. In later months, you might load the boat with yellowfin tuna, catch a 50-pound rooster fish, or get double hookups on marlin. But there's really no bad time to fish the Baja.
I hope you enjoyed today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, there would be no show. So please thank them when you can. Now, get out there and do some great fishing.